The honeybee swarm project is asking questions about structures that honeybees make as part of their reproductive cycle. These are really ginormous swarms where the bees are not flying, but they're actually clinging on each other. The swarm is so big that a bee can say what its neighboring bees are doing, but not what a bee the completely other side of the swarm is doing. We're asking what kind of local information each bee is using to achieve mechanical stability of the entire swarm. And what we found out is that when we shake the bees, the bees inside the swarm start moving around and they collectively change the shape of the swarm. So they start with a cone-like structure with a certain height and base area, and they basically spread out like this. And when we stop the perturbation, they go back to their steady state configuration. And by doing this systematically under different conditions of perturbations that we apply, different frequencies, different accelerations, different directionality, we could pinpoint the local signal that they're using, which seems to be the local deformations each bee is sensing with connections to other bees. And the local rule that they're following is sensing those deformations, and once they reach a certain threshold, they tend to go up the strain or deformation gradient, which makes it harder for an individual bee. But for the collective, it makes the whole swarm more mechanically stable.